Hey guys, I'm Kate. Thank you for tuning into my channel, Hey Kate Red. You've probably seen this trend all over TikTok and Instagram, and I just had to try it out myself. We're going to mix baking soda and paint and apply it to glass vases to give it a really cool ceramic effect. The best part about this project is that you probably have most, if not all, of the materials already in your home. Plus, it's super simple and really affordable too. So let's go ahead and get started. Here are the vases that I got at the thrift store. I have four total, and they're all this green glass kind of green tint. I had this left over from a different project. It is, let's see if you can see it, this chalky finish paint, and I'm doing a white color. This is from Krylon. And you can use whatever you have left over in your house from different projects. You could even go to the store like Home Depot or Lowe's and just get some paint samples for colors you wanted to use too. I of course have the baking soda and then a plate here to mix and a paintbrush. You can pick how much baking soda you want to add to the paint depending on how much texture you want to go with. I'm going to start with doing equal parts of each just by eye, just kind of measuring it out. I've already stirred up my paint and I'm just going to pour a bit on this plate. Like so, probably hard to see the white on white. And I'm just measuring this by eye. Probably do a little bit, stir it up, see how it goes. This is really cool, it's creating a paste. I've already washed these really well, so they are all set to be painted. This is so cool. I'm just loving it already. All right, so I've allowed these to completely dry. They're looking pretty cool and have a really cool texture to them too. I'm loving the way these are looking already. As you can see, there's still a bit of green tint, so we're definitely going to want to do a second coat. I'm hoping they won't need a third coat, but we will see. I just finished the second coat on my first vase and I think it's definitely going to need a third coat for me to be happy. If you had clear glass, I think it would go on better. This green is just really, it's still showing through in my opinion. I'll do a close up here so you guys can see. As I've been working on putting the second coat of paint on all of these vases, I wasn't super happy with the coverage I was getting, so I switched paint brushes, going with a heavier duty, better quality paintbrush, and that seems to be helping, but I think I'm still definitely going to need to put a third coat on all of these. Even with the better paintbrush and putting a really thick coat on, I'm still seeing some of this green show through. So I'm getting ready to start putting my third coat on. And I've got to be honest, I'm not fully in love with how these are turning out, but I'm going to try and see this project through. A couple of things that I have learned in this process. First, I think I went with the wrong type of vase for this type of texture. The vases I picked have a very traditional feel to them, and with this texture, it's kind of boho, and I think I would have been better off going with a more smooth, simpler vase than something so traditionally shaped like this. I also think that I started off with the wrong type of brush. This is more of like a craft painting brush, and I should have stuck with regular paintbrush. Third off, I don't know if it's the green tint to these or if it's the paint that I'm using, but I'm just not getting the coverage that I really wanted. The texture is really cool, and I think it would be awesome for something, again, on a smoother base that could be more boho. But for this, I don't know. It's just not working for me. All right, this is my last phase. I'm putting the third and final coat on this. After this third coat, I can't do any more on this tonight. I'm going to let these dry and check back in the morning and see how I feel about them. But right now, I'm not super pleased. I feel like the coverage just isn't what I want it to be, and I'm so disappointed. Hey guys, I'm back on the couch. I just finished putting my third coat of paint on the vases, and I don't know if I've just had a long day or what, but this project has been a bit of a roller coaster for me. I started off so excited. I couldn't wait to do this project. I was seeing it everywhere, and I think there were quite a few places that if I could just go back and redo this project, I would have done it totally, totally differently. So I hope my mistakes help you. To just kind of recap what I learned along the way, I think the first thing I did wrong was I bought vases that are a little bit more traditional when I should have just bought something really simple that could look a little bit more boho. I would have started off using a better quality paintbrush than I had originally started with. I was using some paint that I just had left over from a previous project. It had a chalky finish to it, and maybe the chalky finish with the baking soda just wasn't the right combination. I don't know. I just was not getting good coverage at all with it. I'm going to let it dry overnight and take a fresh look at it in the morning, and we will see how I feel. I let the vases dry overnight, and the next morning I styled them with a few sprigs of faux eucalyptus on our console table. For these particular vases, I wish I had applied a matte spray paint instead. That would have been a better finish for the style of these vases and a much quicker project. I do plan on trying the baking soda method again, but next time I'll pick simpler vases to achieve that boho style. Have you tried this trend out yet? Comment below and let me know how it turned out. Thank you for watching, and don't forget to subscribe for more simple and affordable DIY tutorials.